and lose our innocence.
Hi, I'm Dave Perowitz, and you're watching me on Biker New England TV.
Let me fly with you, dear angel. Let me fly the distant skies. 'Cause when I'm on your wings, dear angel, I wanna fly. I wanna fly.
Gary Janicek, in front of my 2007 Harley-Davidson edition F-150. I bought it brand new in 07 from Sarah Ford. It's a Harley, like I said, it's a Harley edition. It's Harley did a little thing where they work with Ford, and they have the Harley trucks. I'm sure you've seen a few out there, but on mine, I did a little extra, did some graphics, all Harley stuff, skulls and flames and stuff, from a friend of mine, Joe Ventura, out of Ludlow. He did all the graphics. I did the base. He comes in and does his graphics. We clear over it. But this job is 10, 11 years old. As you can see, I take very good care of my stuff. But I did it at my cousin's shop in East Long Meadow, Bodyworks Unlimited. And the reason I did it is because I like the Harley stuff. And it was a Harley edition, so I figured I'd make it go a little bit further and do some graphics on it. Probably really costly for the average guy because I've done bodywork for 30 years, so I cut the cost down by me doing a lot of the work. But probably if you did something like this, it'd be like $10,000. So saying that, when I first did the truck, you know, everyone thought I was crazy, but that's what I want because I like the Harley stuff. I have a bike I ride. It's like a freedom, you know, it's a symbol of freedom. So when you get on a bike and you just ride and you're all to yourself, no radio, no nothing, it helps you think. It helps me clear my head. But as I was telling you, this truck is a 2007, and that's what really basically inspired me to do it is because of the love of bikes and stuff. So that's my story.
Hi, I'm Dave Perowitz, and you're watching me on Biker New England TV.
At her feet was a footloose man.
today. CDs right over here and t-shirts.
Hey guys, I'm Jody Perowitz, and you're watching me on Bike New England TV.
We're coming back to you again from Tommy's Tattoo Convention, Hartford, Connecticut, the convention center. Awesome show. You've seen some of the stuff that we've been doing already before this. Now, this gentleman's hard to get a hold of. I mean, he's always busy. So we've been back here a few times trying to get him. He was pointed out to us by Tommy. Tommy says, you got to get an interview with him. And we're doing that, finally. I mean, so it's Justin Coppolino.
Yeah.
And he's well known, you know. And I just want to ask you, first of all, thank you for taking the time to sit down and talk with us.
Of course, man, of course.
Justin, this is a show that we do called Biker New England.
Okay.
It's a pretty neat show. We bring you people entertainment from motorcycle builders, fabricators, painters, right? Top shelf stuff, right?
Yeah.
I don't know if you know anything about the motorcycling industry, but we have people on there like Dave Perowitz, who some of his motorcycles sell for $100,000.
Oh,
so
wow.
They appreciate this. He's got tattoos all over his body. You'll want to check out Jody Perowitz, his daughter, at Perowitz.com, fastest woman in the world on a V-twin motorcycle. So big motorcycle stuff we bring.
Okay.
So you fit awesome on there because this is big time stuff.
Yeah.
Tell us where you're from, contact information, and then tell us what got you into this.
Okay, I'm from Philadelphia originally, and I moved around a bunch. I learned how to tattoo in Los Angeles. I moved there in 2004, shortly after, with my band and stuff, trying to get a record deal, being a rock star. You know what I'm saying? Like, and
you paid a price.
Yeah, and then it was like, and then it ended up being like couch surfing. You know, and I was like, whoa, what am I doing? Like. You know, and I left Philadelphia, like, with a great job and everything like that, and I left to try to succeed in music. And I did. I did a lot of big things, and then I fell in love with tattooing. I met a couple people at a shop out there in L.A., and I started learning how to tattoo. And now I'm 13 years later, and I'm, like, I'm traveling, doing all these shows, and I mean, it's how I feed my family, but it's also how I make, like, amazing friends.
You're like at the top echelons of this industry, are you not?
Well, yeah. I mean, there's a lot of great tattoo artists out there, you know. And I mean, I feel so fortunate to have met a ton of them, and meet guys like Tommy, who were like, "Yo, you know what? I'm gonna take you under my wing. I'm gonna hook you up with a sponsorship." And I mean, I'm so grateful for everything that everybody has done for me in my career. There's a lot of us out there, though. You know, I mean, it looks like a small community, but it's extremely large. And with all the TV shows and stuff, it's just grown massive. You know, I mean, it's tough right now because there are so many TV shows, and there are so many people that are jumping into the industry that latch on that probably just look at it more of like a business end. And I didn't get into it for that. Like, I just didn't. I mean, I saw an opportunity with a bunch of cool people, and I was like, whoa, I actually like this. This is so interesting to me. And me and my brother have always been the type of people that, like, if we could do anything we put our minds to, you know, whether it be like kicking a soccer ball into that basket over there, you know what I'm saying? Like, and we'd do it until we got it. And I think that that's where the passion is, you know what I'm saying? A lot of people now, there's a less passion and more business, and I get it. Like, look, with the TV shows, I love what it's done for the industry as far as like growing it and making people aware of it, because people are getting tattooed that would have never gotten tattooed. But I think what we have to do, and I think this may happen, is start educating the clients more. You know, the artists that aren't true at heart, like, they'll fall off. There'll always be them, but if they start educating the clients more, because none of these TV shows educate clients at all. They just don't. That's not their MO. You know, it's like, let me show you how crazy it can get. Well, I think in the meantime, they should try to educate a little more just so their clients are aware, because if they come with a bunch of knowledge, then it's easier on the artist. I mean, it's a tough job, you know, and we try to get everything that we can get in a consultation and all that stuff. I mean, it's a lot of work. And then all of that's done, and now you got to apply it to the skin. That's a whole separate thing, you know? And so it's a lot, man. And but you know what? Again, like, I feel fortunate that I was able to do this in my life and I'm constantly giving back to the community. Constantly giving back. Like, coming to these shows, I mean, you know, spending the airfare, getting, you know, always supporting people's art and prints and buy, you know, and buying products from different companies. Like, it's, you know, it's all giving back, and I think that a lot of artists should do that more, you know, and yeah, if they can, you know, some just can't afford it, can't do it, you know, and they're just squeaking by, but this is amazing.
It's a shame that we grow older and lose our innocence.